In today's Mystery from History, let's tackle a really sticky subject. Glue. We are surrounded by mysteries from science we don't actually fully understand. But as clever humans, we use the properties of physics without needing to understand how they work. And here's a classic demonstration of an everyday object that until recently, we didn't fully understand how it stuck together. Let's make a jam sandwich. Put the jam all over the bread. Let's have more jam. Make a really good jammy sandwich. And get the top. Put it on. So what you've got is two bits of dry bread and some slippery jam. But watch this. The two bits of bread stick together. What's really happening inside my jam sandwich is cohesion. The jam wants to stick together to itself, but in fact doesn't stick very well to the bread. And that's how a contact adhesive works. It's all about the glue being sticky, but not necessarily sticking to the surface. Anything that you need to stick together has unique properties. Think of the difference between sticking two flat planes together or sticking points together. I am not an adhesive expert, but just like you, I use glue all the time. It's very handy. So let's get into the sticky subject of how contact adhesive works in the case of the jam sandwich. It's all about this fancy word, cohesion. And all that means is the glue sticks to itself. It's tacky. And you all know how to use contact adhesive. You must put it on both surfaces and then join them together. It's the stickiness of the glue to itself which holds up the size of the surface. No good for single points, but great for flat sheets. And that's because the glue has cohesion to itself, but very little adhesion to the surfaces. So is there a universal glue that will stick anything together? The answer is no. A lot of people might mention crazy glue, super glue, or to use its fancy name, cyanoacrylate. The way that super glue works is completely different from contact adhesive, and it's really clever. Did you know that the best super glue is the super runny one, not the medium or the gel type? The super runny one has a unique quality. It's made up of these tiny individual molecules that only when they dry do they join together into chains. And the best substances to stick together with super glue are anything that's slightly porous. Wood, ceramics, but it's not that good for glass or metal. How it works is, in the absence of air, it joins together and makes a mechanical bond between itself and the porous object. It's actually making a lock. And that's the second principle of glue, mechanical adhesion. And now we come to a real mystery that's only recently been solved. How a droplet of water sticks to a pane of glass. Next time it rains, watch how the water behaves. See how the rain naturally clumps into droplets because of the word that you've now learned, cohesion. But it sticks to the surface of the glass due to adhesion. The drops only fall down the windowpane when they're too heavy for the adhesive forces to keep them in place. So you need a unique glue for every application. And here are four different sticky types. There's adsorption. Absorption is a surface sticking effect caused by small attractive forces between the adhesive. There's chemical absorption, We use this all the time when joining plastics together. It actually welds the plastic into one piece. There's diffusion, and this sticks together when molecules cross the boundaries from one piece into the other. And then there's mechanical adhesion. This works when the glue goes into porous parts of the two things you're sticking together. Now, some clever glues use all of these properties and try and combine them to be a universal glue, but you really do need to fit the glue to the application. Well, I hope that was a good introduction to the sticky subject of glue. Time for my breakfast. It's hungry work discovering that the truth is out there. I'm getting hungry because the truth is out there.